stage gate's only part of it. Very often, a process designed with the best of intentions often ends up thwarting innovation because it's so cumbersome, so bureaucratic, so painful to get through. And some people have told me privately in their companies because their process is so rigid and old-fashioned that it's stopping innovation. And I say, isn't that a shame? Because the original model was based on entrepreneurs and innovators. So you've lost something along the way. So the first thing we're always encouraging people is let's get back to basics here and let's make sure that the model that you're using is true to the original concept of StageGate, an entrepreneurial guide for moving projects from idea to launch, not a paper form filling out exercise. Okay, guys, let's get back to basics on that. But more, companies have evolved the process to make it, I use three A's here. You know, the first is to make it much more adaptive. In the old days, for example, you typically would define the project and the product very early on. You got a product definition, a set of specs, and then you would charge into development and develop the product and then get into field trials, and then everything would go wrong because it's not quite right, not quite what the customer wanted. Well, today we're talking a very adaptive process. You build something very early on. You don't wait till after development. You start it even before development. A virtual product, a protocept, a crude working model, a cardboard cutout, something that you can demonstrate to the stakeholders, to management, and also to the customers. You seek feedback. You basically make revisions. So the whole thing is based on a series of spirals or loops. Build, test, feedback, revise. Build, test, feedback, revise. All the way through the process to get the product right and get it right early before you've spent a lot of money and gone down the wrong road. So the notion here is get something in front of customers early, often, cheap, and fast, because people don't know what they're looking for until they see it. So get it in their face, get it in front of them. So that's one of the things, and that's a very adaptive process where the product evolves rather than is defined up front, because defining it up front, usually it's wrong, and then you're faced with all kinds of problems later in the game. A second thing that we're seeing a lot of, a second A, is it's much more agile than it used to be. The software writers wrote the Agile Manifesto a number of decades ago, and they taught us a lot of things about the emphasis should be on results, not on documentation. That you should break the process into a series of time box sprints of 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 weeks and produce something at the end of that. Well, software development is a lot different than physical development, physical product development, like a food product or a machine. So sometimes you can't translate all the principles into physical product development, but some you can. We can break the development phase into a series of 3-week or 4-week sprints in which you have to deliver something at the end of that, and not a PowerPoint presentation. We can make the process be very nimble, moving from milestone to milestone all the way along. We can place a heavier emphasis on results rather than documentation. These are some of the lessons we learned from the Agile guys. And I think people are building that into their stage gate processes. And finally, acceleration. That's the third A. People are overlapping stages. People are making the process much more context-based, meaning you don't use a big process for a small project. You know, we've got our big process for our big projects, we got our medium-sized process for extensions, modifications, and fixes, and we got our two-stage, two-gate, small, lightweight process called StageGate Express. These are the salesman's projects, Salesforce projects, and they move through very quickly. So you don't use big processes for little projects. Doesn't mean you bypass the process altogether. So people are doing that. And there's a number of other things that people are using to accelerate the process. The use of lean approaches, Lean Six Sigma. Great methodology for improving the way the factory operates. How about improving the way product development is done? Every time we've applied value stream analysis to the innovation process, we're able to cut out all kinds of time and all kinds of waste in the process. If it doesn't add value, get rid of it. Value stream analysis, a great way to do this. And so people are trying to accelerate the process by making it leaner, by making it context-based, by overlapping stages and activities. And also, one more thing I should point out, since I know who you work for, by introducing automation, because IT support of the stage gate process and portfolio management does, in fact, and has been proven, to accelerate the process considerably.